The rules and the regulations, they burden and they confuse people, and yet you will not lift a burden to lift a burden or a finger to help them. In verse number 5 through 11, they wanted to be seen by others. Talking about the scribes and the Pharisees. They wanted to be called certain names. Rabbi. Today, it's apostle, it's prophet, it's doctor, it's bishop. The names are so important. The title is so important. And my Bible tells me, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, he's giving you a title. It's called ambassador.
Yes.
You're an ambassador. Amen. But we want to feel so important. We notice that. We see that today in the church world.
Yeah.
In verse number 12, he says, and whoever exalts himself will be humbled or put down. And he who humbles himself will be exalted or lifted up. Amen. Look at verse number 13. But woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you shut up the kingdom of heaven against men. For you neither go in yourselves, nor do you allow those who are entering to go in. See what hypocrisy will do? You won't go in a deeper relationship with the Father. And you won't allow others. Why? Because of your lifestyle.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
He says, woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you devour widows' houses, and for a pretense make long prayers. Therefore, you will receive a greater condemnation. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you travel land and sea to win one proselyte. And when he is won, you make him twice as much a son of hell as you are, or you yourselves are. So your lifestyle turns others into something that's not pleasing to God. Out of the heart of man flows the issues of life. Out of the heart of us comes every evil work. I'm almost finished. Hang in there with me.
Yeah.
Proverbs 4:23 says, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it flows the issues of life. And when you look at that scripture, he talks about the words that we speak out of our mouth. Words that are condemning, words that are judgmental, the things that we say, out of the abundance of the heart, Jesus said, the mouth speaks. In Matthew chapter 15, talks about the heart. Write down Proverbs 4. You can look at that at your leisure. 4, verse 23. In chapter 15 of Matthew, Jesus says this concerning the heart. But those things which proceed out of the mouth come from where? The heart. And they defile a man. For out of the heart proceeds evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witnesses, blasphemy. False witnesses. Bearing false witness comes from where? The heart. Hypocrisy comes from where? The heart. These things, verse number 20, these are things which defile a man, but to eat with unwashed hands does not defile a man. So out of the heart, proverb writer tells us to do what? Guard the heart. For out of it flows the issues of life. The problem that we're having in the world are because of a people who have a heart that's unclean. Clean the heart will change the issues of life.
That's right.
I said a clean heart, cleaning the heart, a clean heart will change the issues of life. A greedy man is greedy because of his heart. A jealous man, jealous because of his heart. But the only thing, understand something, the world would have you to think that drugs, alcohol, illicit sex, more money will change the heart. None of those things will change your heart. None of them. The only thing that will change the heart of a man is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's it. A man that is dealing in addiction, we send him to rehab. A man that is dealing in sex addiction, we send him to rehab. A man dealing in drug addiction, we send him to rehab. But the only rehab that will work is the rehab of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's it. Why?
That's
because
right.
It's a heart issue.
That's right.
It's a heart issue. Oh yeah, you can send them to a psychiatrist. You can send them to a therapist. There's people that have been in therapists for decades. And nothing has changed. It hasn't changed. Why? Because of the heart. It's a heart issue. Jesus says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Out of the abundance of the heart, there's the issues of life. Every issue in life is as a result of what? The heart. And hypocrisy comes from where? The heart. The only answer is the Lord Jesus. The only answer is to thirst for him. Mm. Last verse, and I'm going to stop here. And you can go home and eat that turkey. Lord, we have to. John chapter number 7. I pray that the Holy Spirit will bring this all to life.
Yes, amen.
Look at what he says. John 7, verse number 37. Here's the answer. Here's the answer right here. Yeah, I know I said it's the Lord Jesus. But look what Jesus says here. He says 37. On the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts, let him come and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart, his belly, King James says, will flow rivers of living water.
That's right.
This is the thing that changes love. But this, 39, he spoke concerning the Spirit, whom those believing in him would receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. But we know Jesus has been glorified. We know that the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, is present in the earth right now. And anyone who thirsts can come to him. The only thing that will change the heart of a man is the power of the Holy Spirit and the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
So true.
The spirit of hypocrisy, yes, it's running rampant in the world, but it can be defeated by the power of the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
Amen. Yes. Stand on your feet. Thank you, Lord.